So, really, who cares about harmonics? If you think about it from a designer standpoint, or if you're a consultant, if you're designing a building, if you're designing a facility, a water treatment plant for your customer, you care about harmonics if you're putting in a whole bunch of variable frequency drives, if you're putting a bunch of rectifiers in, things that are going to create harmonic currents, push them back out onto the system, because you want your system to be robust. You don't want your customer to come back to you 10 years from now and say, hey, I've got a problem, it's related to harmonics, you did a poor design. The people that are operating the facility, like plant operators and so forth, care about it because in their mind, if something misoperates or doesn't work right, it's going to come back to them, and they have to worry about, you know, how are they going to fix the problem. So again, the designer first, thinking ahead of time, the people operating the facility second. Operating the facility would have problems if they have harmonic current and voltage distortion issues. As far as the end user, that could be me or you. We could be in our house, we could have harmonic currents flowing from LED lights, we could see lights flickering, we could see our TVs acting funny. So as an end user, it could be down to a residential level, or it could be, again, at a plant level or a larger facility system level. Now, as far as salespeople, when you think about a salesperson, if I'm selling you variable frequency drives and I want you to have the best system you can have, you might ask me, hey, I want to comply with IEEE 519. I want to reduce my harmonic currents to a very low level. And as a salesperson, it's kind of my job to instruct you or help guide you to the right level of distortion. If I sell you, if I oversell you a bunch of harmonic solutions that maybe you don't need, then that's, in my mind, that's a problem, because I've cost you a lot more money than you really should have spent. If I sell you the right amount of equipment at the right level, depending on the size of your system and the amount of harmonic current and things that's going to be generated by those loads, then I've done a good job. And then finally, who really cares about it also is the utility. Now think about the utility as the mediator. So if I'm producing harmonics and you're next door to me as a hospital maybe, and I create harmonics and distort the voltage in the incoming part of your system, you're going to be upset with me, but the utility is the mediator. That's where the point of common coupling, or the utility, point where the utility can kind of guide both customers to make sure that I don't affect you and vice versa if needed. So again, who cares about harmonics? All of these different people. And I've been in situations where I've sat around a table with all of these people in one room. And I'll give you an example. One time, you know, it was a large water treatment plant. The designer wanted to put a lot of harmonic solutions in the system. And I asked a simple question. I said, what's the voltage distortion in your models showing you? And they said, well, we'll have, you know, 40% current distortion, but we'll have about 1% voltage distortion. And I said, I don't think you have a problem. And they didn't like that, but at first I talked them through it. And I said, just because you have a lot of current distortion doesn't mean you're going to have issues, because if that's the only load on your system, then you're not going to have necessarily a lot of 60 hertz current kind of drowning out that percent distortion. But the actual amps that are causing the voltage distortion, if you only have 1% voltage distortion, you'll be fine. So again, those people care about harmonics. We all care about it. Let's try to do the right thing from a cost perspective and design perspective.